close to you.
Yesterday I was talking to a Christian worker, and he talked about how he was disciplined because of something that he had done. And the week after he was disciplined, the leader who disciplined him asked him to go and do something, some public ministry. They needed somebody to speak or something like that. And they asked him to do it. And, you know, how sad. You discipline a person because he needs to be godly. And then when you have a program and you have no one, you forget about the godliness for the sake of the program. Our greatest desire is that people will walk to the Lord. I mean, the result of this is that they will be faithful to the tasks that have been assigned to them. Today we have job descriptions and reports that have to be written and supervisors who have to check up on various aspects. And I think this is helpful. I think they help people to be faithful. They describe the details of faithfulness. This is what it means to be faithful in your job. You have to do this, this, this and this. But the heart of faithfulness is clinging to God. That's the heart of faithfulness, of wanting to please Him. And if you do cling to God, you have a sense of a call from God to do your job, and you will do your job well. But because lethargy is a part of our nature and all of that, sometimes you may need things like, you know, reports and you know, all the job descriptions and all of that. Especially as organizations get bigger. That's what we found at the start. We didn't have job descriptions. My big job was to keep these people from working too hard. I would force them to take a holiday and all of that. As the ministry got bigger, we had new problems. And some of them are not working as well as they should and all of that. So people have lethargy as part of their weakness. So we need these. But those are not the most important things about anybody. So the heart of faithfulness is clinging to God, wanting to please Him. So here we have seen five qualities of an encourager. I'll stop there and then get on to another session a little later. But surrender of personal right to control our life. Risk-taking, being public relations officers, grace and faith-colored vision as we look at people, and exhorting people to faithfulness. Let's pray. Father, it's easy for me to talk like this, but we all know that ministry is complex. People hurt us, and very often so difficult for us to think positively about ministry, about people. Oh God, give us a vision of grace. Help us, Lord, to realize how great your grace is. And may that grace be a constant source of rejoicing in our life. Oh, may we be people who are thrilled by Jesus. And may the thrill that we have about Jesus be the thing that makes us warm, yearn to see other people being used by you. Minister to us, we pray in Jesus' name.
Into preparing this message that Brother
to, in relation to whatever that you think this conference is all about. Hallelujah. It doesn't seem very glorious to have a ministry of encouragement. It's a background kind of ministry. And in the light of what we have just heard from the exposition of the person Barnabas, it's like others will actually become better than us. Recently I was telling a guy called Master Ron. Then Sunday I wasn't preaching, I was sitting down and was watching him operate. Then I told him, and I think you have stepped into my shoes now, and it is well with my soul. And I told him that I meant it. But I have a suspicion whether how many percent that I really mean it, or would I at some stage stealthily, maybe still harbor, maybe envy, if he is really much more successful than I am? Would I be so big hearted that my successors and my leaders under me would really be much, much bigger than me, or more effective than what I've done? I went to God about it and asked God, Lord, the only way that I can pray at that point in time was, Lord, you better help me, because I do not know how much dross and sin in my flesh I still have. The fact that maybe I have a suspicion, it shows that God, for the purpose of the kingdom, really, this thing called dying to self is not easy. I thought I've done it all my life. Up to now, at least, I thought I did. But when I thought about it, I really have to settle within my heart that it is indeed well with my soul when a young girl is actually exceeding the older. And I would that all of them in my group, in our group, would be better and more effective, simply because the work in this world needs to be done by more people, and maybe even greater people than us. But the Lord has assigned me this job to be a responder, and to encourage us all to be responders to the speakers. And so last night we had a portion of it, and this morning I'm sure, absolutely sure, that when our speaker preaches generally, the Holy Spirit will speak to us specifically. Just make our personal altar before God. Shall you rise and just allow God to have an encounter with us as we hear some of the truths that are being expounded? They are revelation of God's word to us. I just learned not too long ago that revelation doesn't necessarily change us if revelation does not proceed to God's word to us that will be, that will lead us into an encounter with Jesus this morning. That we will actually now see a greater weight in the spirit of Barnabas in this particular ministry of encouragement that is so necessary. For God's purpose in raising fathers in the kingdom of God. And my thinking right now is this concept of surrender, so that we can release the spiritual sons and daughters in the fullness of their potential, releasing them, or we are surrendered enough to release them so that they can be effective through the mistakes and through the things that may sometimes frustrate us, or maybe sometimes the disrespect due to their growing up years, maybe in their pride, in their flesh, they might have even sometimes shown disrespect towards us. But if we have died, if we are dead, you're dead. But if they are doing well, we can still sing that song, "It is well with my soul." As we are now standing right in front before God in our hearts, let this be a time of a transaction, a spiritual transaction between us and God. Lord Jesus, let your light shine in our hearts to purify us, so that we can have such an intimate relationship with you as we walk in the light, as we endeavor to walk in the light as you are in the light. And then we fellowship one with another, particularly with you right now. That Father God, we will want to respond to this particular message on the ministry of encouragement. Ministry of encouragement. This is despite the fact that sometimes we ourselves need encouragement too. But then again, Father, it is a surrendered moment that when we will bless others, you will be the one who will bless us. That's your promise to Abraham. Oh, bless them that bless you. So those guys who bless you will be blessed by God. And if we bless others, we become the one that will be blessed by God. And I just pray, Father God, that you would just begin to capture now every heart right now. Brothers and sisters, as you're standing in the face of the Lord, encountering God right now through this message of the encouragement ministry, let God begin to actually focus you on the very specific thing that the Lord might have directed your attention to just now, when our dear brother was speaking generally out from his own heart. Of course, there were so many specific things that my brother encountered God in to be able to come up with a message such as that. We have heard. But now it's our turn. That Father God, we ourselves need to so cling to you right now, so that you can look through our weaknesses. There's a chance that we have to be like Barnabas, that now maybe look at a certain person with eyes tinted with grace, so that we can be free from the burden of anger against some mistakes made, so that we can be free from the burden of past mistakes made. And sometimes those mistakes might have actually affected us ourselves. Father, we surrender. We take risk. We may have to speak well of another, to profile the other person, so that the person can step into his destiny. Grace colored vision, clinging to God in faithfulness. Father, for every point of focus that my brothers and sisters are making right now in their prayer to you towards you, right at this time, as we stand before you.